We've just left South Africa and we're currently sailing in the Indian Ocean. Unfortunately, our voyage is going to diverge somewhat from Captain Ross's aboard Terror and Erebus. After leaving South Africa, Ross and Crozier sailed on across the Atlantic to Kerguelen Island. They reached there in May 1840 and stayed until July, performing magnetic experiments, and then travelled on to Hobart on Tasmania, or Van Diemen's Land as it was at the time. There, the governor, Sir John Franklin, was eagerly awaiting their arrival. He'd been appointed governor about 2 years earlier, with the belief that he had a mission to implement some sort of scientific renaissance of the penal colony, in which the science of magnetism would be central. When Terror and Erebus arrived in August 1840, they unloaded equipment to establish the third of their magnetic observatories under the command of a Lieutenant Kay. But this was not just a reunion of magnetic enthusiasts. This represented the coming together of no fewer than four Fox Needles. Captain James Clark Ross obviously had his 7-inch needle aboard Erebus, and aboard Terra was Crozier's 4-inch needle. But at Cape Verde, they had requested a second 7-inch Fox needle from Falmouth that was dispatched. And by the time they got to Hobart, it was there waiting to be equipped to Terra. But there was in fact a fourth Fox needle in Hobart, and this was probably Fox's original magnetic dip needle that he gifted to Sir John Franklin. So we actually find that at Hobart, we don't just have the coming together of Ross, Franklin and Crozier, but of no fewer than four Fox needles. Captain Ross and Crozier landed in Hobart and they went straight to the governor's house, where they found a phenomenally enthusiastic Sir John Franklin and Sir Lady Franklin as well, a bit of a magnetic enthusiast herself. They set out and found a location for the observatory, and within 9 days they'd constructed the observatory of what became known as Ross Bank. The speed with which they were able to erect this observatory was thanks very much to the support of Sir John, and also the fact that he managed to provide quite a large force of convict labourers to build it. Terra and Erebus remained at Hobart before then travelling down to the Antarctic. During 1841, they would reach the latitude of 88 degrees, and it would be with James Clark Ross's Fox Needle that he would take this measurement of 88 degrees, which was as close as he could physically get to the South Magnetic Pole. In fact, he could pinpoint where the South Magnetic Pole was, but unfortunately, it was on land. It turns out that Antarctica is a landmass, so the ships were unable to reach it. Despite the failure of actually not being able to reach the South Magnetic Pole, they did make a range of discoveries: the Ross Ice Shelf, the Ross Sea. They found a live volcano, which they fittingly named Mount Erebus, and another one that they named Mount Terror. They also named a series of mountains after